Behold my stuff.
Face, fire with it, anger with it, anger.
The fuck? Hey, Lois, are you sure this place is for men?
Yes, Peter, it's for everyone.
Really? Because this kind of looks like a dress.
Peter, it's fine. Come on out. Ha! You gay ball!
Life does not... Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Reading another one of your dirty girl books?
Romantic.
Mutiny from behind.
Yeah. The mutiny sneaks up on her.
I don't think that's what it means.
Well, it is a wonderful book. It's got pirates in action. Oh. It has this hilarious parrot that says the most inappropriate things.
I hear so many people say they would not survive in a fantasy world. And for me, it comes down to this. Would I rather have anxiety about getting to work on time, how much money I spend on gas, people, or would I rather have anxiety about getting eaten by a dragon, being really bad at sword fighting, running for my life from a hot, chiseled, morally gray character? I would go with the latter. I would still have anxiety. It would just have a little more flavor.
Are you kidding me?
Stormy? You look like mommy, baby.
If you would like to read a book that is so beautifully written, it will feel like it has carved out a piece of your heart and handed it to you, I have a recommendation. It is a queer feminist revisiting of Frankenstein, and if that didn't convince you, it is also one of my most tabbed books of all time.
He was the best guy around.
What about the people he murdered?
What murder?
Maybe I read too much, but do you ever see something and you're like, oh my God, this fell right out of a romance novel? That happened to me this week.
I saw this sign. It's a tattoo parlor and a cake shop. And you go down the hallway and look at this. Look, you guys, look. That's the tattoo parlor on the right. And that is the cake shop on the left. They obviously have to have fallen in love and are girlfriends who live upstairs, right? Like, there is no other explanation for this. Someone write this book.
He's a 9.5, but you dated his son.
I dated his son?
I know. Is that gross? We should do a different
10.
Already a 9, and he's the older, better version of somebody I already dated? Please.
But you dated his son.
So we're in the Cursed Woods battling the Knights of Darkness for like the fifth time in a fortnight because their power is regenerating in the moonlight. It's exhausting. Anyway, one of them has me pinned here against a tree and Rylakon is unconscious in the dirt. I thought it was a goner. But the last second, Rye gains consciousness. Give me a half. Gains consciousness, okay? Sees me. Stumbles over. Grabs his sword. Delivers the final blow. Catches himself on the tree, okay? I'm here. And then he just puts a finger under my chin and lifts and says, are you hurt?
Ah! Not what?
You know what I did next. Don't make me say it.
Don't make me say it.
I hear you say it. I let out a breath. I didn't know
you
I was
You let out a breath you didn't know you were holding. You never let out a breath you didn't know you were holding?
No, never. Our lives are so different.
I'm just gonna say it. I think it's super creepy you get sexually aroused by physical violence.
Well, but also emotional violence.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's even creepier.
you to know that the author who wrote this, the author of this book, you're sick. You are so sick. You are so sick. Why would you do this to me? The bitch who wrote this book, V.E. Schwab, you need to be, what's your full fucking name? Victoria V.E. Schwab, you need to be locked away. Why would you end the book that way? I don't want to show my face. I'm embarrassed. Well, why the fuck would you end the book this way?
Catch me if you can, Mr. Holmes.
Oh my god, he said, who did this to you? Oh, my organs, they feel like butter. They do, and my spine, I think it's gone. My spine is gone. I can't feel my fingers anymore. That was unexpected. That was never been done before. That's unique. That's different. She's doing different things. I feel nothing and everything. I am going to die.
Go to the store. Buy a bottle of hoisin sauce. Open the fridge. Oh no! I have a bottle of hoisin sauce. Go to the store. Buy a bottle of hoisin sauce. Open the fridge. Oh no! I already have a bottle of hoisin sauce. Go to the store. Buy a bottle of hoisin sauce. Open the fridge. Oh no! I've already got a bottle of hoisin.
Hard pass. Hard pass. Hard pass. Hard pass.
Isn't it amazing?
I just gotta be honest. I don't know what the big deal is.
Get out.
I have a question for BookTok, specifically for any readers who might have been or are currently in a situation similar to mine. I've been in a reading slump for the past few months. My worst one yet. And I can't seem to figure out how to get out of it. My current theory is that I haven't been in the education system for over a year now. And I'm therefore not in a high-stakes, stress-inducing, traumatizing situation 24/7. I'm not reading as a coping mechanism anymore. It means I have to read just because I want to read and not because my life is shit. And I don't really want to go back into a traumatizing situation. So what else can I do? Because I want to keep reading. So far to fix this, I have tried crying, sobbing, and yoga, and none of it seems to be working. If anyone's got any advice, what I can do, please let me know. I don't like the real world, and I don't want to mentally be here anymore.
What? Girl, look. Baby, I can't read all that shit. Don't worry about it.
You sound like a fucking munchkin.
You seem like a guy who's all in all the time. You don't do anything halfway.
Very insightful, Sharon. Very, very insightful.
Okay, now how long is your PTO from the quest? Half a fortnight. A week. Okay. And how is it being the chosen one? Oh my god, you're like literally living my dream. It's a nightmare, honestly.
But no.
It is. It is, but only because this oracle said that my destiny is tied to Rylakon, of all people, so I have to do this whole quest with him. Wait, like, the Rylakon from book one? Yes. Okay, I didn't even get to tell you this part. The last night before this break, okay, we've been wandering through the Cursed Woods for like four fortnights, okay? 2 months. And we finally find a tavern. All I want is just some stew, some bread, maybe a little cheese and honey mead, mm-hmm. and to like go to sleep by myself. The entire place only had one bed left, and we had to share. Get out, how was it? I mean, it was fine until I woke up with the plague in the middle of the night and then he had to save me using his body heat. Oh, I'm sorry, he had to use his body heat? Yeah, like he just had to like hold me, you know, until my fever broke. It wasn't like— Yeah, because you can just get an extra blanket from the front desk. It's a tavern in the middle of the Cursed Woods, girl. This isn't the Hilton we're talking about. Okay, but seriously, how was it? It was really nice and tender and sweet, and I honestly can't stop thinking about it.
Frick. This is going to be a problem, isn't it?
You know, I was born with a rare body style. You know, the doctors, when I was born, some of the doctors said I had the rib cage of a large cat. And some of the doctors said I had the heart of a lesbian. That, you know.
I was going to say, if in 10 years' time the two of us aren't married, let's promise each other to hunt each other for sport.
To hunt each other for sport.
Is that, did you just agree?
I was hoping you'd say, let's just get married. Let's live together. I'll be your buddy.
also, I don't know.
It's whack-a-doodle time. It is whack-a-doodle time.
I tried to be supportive for Lily. I really did, but I wanted to kill myself.
Oh, no. This can't be.
Pop, you are book shopping in Canada. This is like 130 pages. This is a paperback. For a hardcover. Ah, this is your. This isn't even a book. OML. This is tiny.
This man is disgusting. He's a filthy villain. He respects his wife. And he really loves his kids. And he has actually done nothing wrong. In fact, I love him.